Sweden and the neighboring nation Finland for the third place position in the tournament. The Swedish team is being called onto the field. We'll bring you the starting offense here. Our starting defense for the Swedish team is on the screen. Introducing the Finnish team here quickly. Coach, what do you think?
Well, I think the weather's much better than it was last night. This ninth game of our seventh day, I guess. I can't even remember the days. It's been here quite a while. But we're certainly expecting a closer game today than we've had any time so far. I think these teams are fairly evenly matched. Who gets the best breaks and who's got the best kicking game may be the determiner of how the game turns out. Expecting a close game and a very interesting game.
It might fall down to special teams today. You never really know.
Right. I think the kicking game is going to be very important. As it always is, but whenever.
On the screen there, you have the defense of Sweden, or of Finland, excuse me.
Finland's defense is being introduced as you look at it on the screen. Hopefully you can see it at home, but it's a little shaky on our monitor, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Technical assistance from the men in the truck. Get us up and running.
And here are the standings up to game number nine. Japan in the lead with 196. Mexico with 170. Sweden with minus 78. Finland with minus 90. And China bringing up the rear with minus 197. As Coach was saying, it should be a close game today. A little bit better matchup than what we've seen this week. We're hoping to break the egg barrier and get both teams on the scoreboard. As the teams are lined up for the national anthems of Finland and Sweden.
As you mentioned before, I think you did, Coach Will anyway, that this game is for the bronze medal. And in this first World Championship game of American football, or tournament, rather. So there's a lot riding on it other than just pride for the teams across the sea from each other.
A little bit of bragging rights involved.
How far is Finland from Sweden?
Distance-wise, they touch each other up in the north, so a couple of meters, but but to travel there, it'd take you, by boat, it'd take you about 12 hours.
So it wouldn't take too long to fly there, right?
No.
Okay.
About an hour flight.
I'm not figuring on going by boat. Cool, overcast day, but no rain. A little bit of moisture in the air earlier today, but certainly none so far this afternoon. I don't even think we'll expect any throughout the game.
Today's game is brought to you by the sponsor here, Landslaget. We'd like to thank Mr. Bill Marsh for everything he's done for the tournament. And here, Landslaget, who have given us all kinds of equipment so our cameras get good views. Lots and lots of miles of cable.
He's even taken me out on a boat ride and helped me catch a fish.
There you go,
he's
Coach.
He's quite a guy.
Steady stream of people coming in the gates through the game. Hopefully we'll have a good crowd for today's game.
I think Mr. Soderberg was expecting this to maybe be the largest crowd we've had so far during the tournament, simply because of the two teams that's matched up. Tomorrow's game, we'll talk a little bit more about that as the day goes along, but it certainly, we would expect it to have a lot of excitement too for the gold medal match between Mexico and Japan.
Sweden's captains for today are number 99, Marcus Janbach, number 58, Daniel Riesberg, number 20, Joshua Kenna, and number 9, Fabian Söderberg. For Finland is number 65, Hannes Mattila. Number 9, Antero Shivanen. And the third one, I can't exactly see his shirt from here, but I'll get that name to you.
I don't either, but as I'm looking out there thinking we don't have the weights and heights of our respective players, but number 65, I would expect to tip it up a few pounds and maybe even kilos as here in Europe, there's some pounds.
Hannes Mattila, number 65 of Finland, as Coach is talking about there, born 1990. Height 189 centimeters, weight 150 kilos, puts him right around 300 pounds, Coach.
Large young man.
The third captain for Finland was the quarterback, Sebastian Bernson, number 5. And Sweden will be kicking off to Finland to start the game here. Game number 9 of the 2014 World University of American Football Championship.
Said earlier, we expect the kicking game to be very important today. It always is important in the outcome of the game. I think the closer your opponents are matched, potentially at least the more it can come into play.
Coach Billgren of Sweden resting a few players in the game against Japan. Looking ahead to this game. One of those players was number six, running back Hampus Hellemark. Would have liked to see him run against the Japanese, actually.
He's a fine young player.
Back to return for Finland is Heckley and Siskonen. Elenius' kick is taken at midfield by Siskonen. Hit hard by Johannes Nilsson at the 25-yard line, driving him back another couple of yards.
Very good catch. I think you're a very good tackle. I think you're going to mark it about the 23. 22, the PA system says.
Brings out the Finnish offense.
Finland will start their offense at the 22-yard line. First and 10.
First and 10 from the 22.
Got a slot eye formation.
Single back Arakasanen gets the ball in the middle and hit hard at the line. Brought down by big number 95 of Sweden, Kenneth Frickler.
I believe Sweden came with a double E-gap blitz. Start the game. See if that's a sign of things to come. Or
be marked down as a loss. Ball is placed on the 20-yard line. Bring up second and 12.
For loss of the yards, second down and 11.
I formation, Rotala at fullback. Looking to throw is Berntsen going down the right side. Open to Heckley, who catches the ball at the 40-yard line. Brought down at the 45. They'll mark him down at the 46-yard line.
Number one receiver runs a fade route. Just behind the corner. For a nice gain.
Brings first and 10 for the Finnish team at midfield at the 46-yard line.
That trips to the wide side of the field this time. Single setback.
Berntsen changing the play at the huddle, or at the line of scrimmage, excuse me. Hand off to the running back, Arakasanen, over the 50-yard line, brought down at the 48 of Sweden.
By number seven,
Team Finland
gain of 6 yards.
Team Finland is able to do that simply because of Attila's versatility. He lines up as a fullback, lines up as an H-back, and he also lines up as the inside slot. He was fairly wide that time.
Not to mention he's also a linebacker.
Yes, sir.
And a special teams player.
Yes. They get a lot of mileage out of that young man.
I formation, two receivers to the right side. Hand off to Rakesson, and again, near the first down marker where he's brought down. They'll mark him down as a fumble. But the line judge is calling ball dead. They'll give it to Finland. They'll bring up a third down. Third down and 1 yard to go. From our angle, we couldn't see if he was down or not, but the line judge's angle was a lot better than ours, so he saw it.
An old-fashioned buck type play there, trying to get the linebackers to not always be able to key on the fullback.
Third and one for Finland at the Sweden 45-yard line. Single back. Hand off to Rakasanen, first down and a little bit more. They'll mark it down as a 5 yard gain.
Very good line surge that time by Team Finland. Whole line of scrimmage was moving north.
Brings up first and 10 from the 42 yard line of Sweden.
Actually, I don't know if that direction is north, but it's north to me when we're playing football.
They're actually running towards the east, coach. But I can understand when you're not in the middle of Atchison, you don't know which way is left or right, up or down. Looking to throw is Burnson. Puts it out to his receiver. Catches the ball. Rotel on the reception. Bring up second down and 6.5 for the Finns.
He lined up as the inside slot again on that particular play. Released out into the flat on a narrow type route. The pass would have been a little more in the air. Probably picked up a few more yards. High slot formation, slot to the wide side of the field.
High formation once again. False start by the offense.
Big right tackle. Looked like he was getting ready to pull. Think they was going to run a counter play.
False start by the offense. Right tackle moved a little bit too quickly there.
That means we're going to second and 12.
Brings up second and 11 and a half for the Finnish team.
We're still 43 yards out from the goal line, but Team Finland's already had the ball 4 minutes.
We got us a football game, Coach. 7:56 remaining in the first quarter of play.
Trips again.
Finland versus Sweden.
To the field.
Burnson looking to throw swing pass out to Rakkisen. Ball hits the turf and they call it dead.
Pass intended for Matti Rakkisen.
Bring up third and long situation.
Third down and long.
First one for Team Finland today.
Brings a third and 12 for the Finns. Might see a bit of a draw play here. If Burnson doesn't go deep. Rotola is at the slot on the left side. Keep your eyes on number 32. The ball might be going there. Goes down the right side. Caught by Heckley at the 30-yard line. First down.
Great catch.
Kind of a sloppy throw, but a great catch. Diving catch over the sideline.
Will the change work? Rennie's route behind that. Got a great pass. Great catch.
First and 10 for Finland from the Swedish 30-yard line. Trips left, single back, handoff to Rakkisen. Up the left side, hit hard at the line, but still digs for a couple yards. Close to the 24-yard line, or excuse me, 26-yard line. They'll mark him at the 26. Gain of 4.
7 minutes to go.
Brings up second down and 6. Swedish defense has been on the field quite a long time. 6 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the first quarter play. I formation, handoff Harakison and hit hard at the line of scrimmage, no gain. Brought down by,
run again by number 7.
Big
Matti
number
Arakisen.
98.
And again, stopped by number 95, Kenneth Rickler.
Excuse me,
Sweden.
95 Rickler,
so
who's still on the field. Medical crew coming out to attend to him.
Looks like he's reaching for his knee. I don't know whether that's indicative of the injury or not.
Looked like the tackle next to him came down on his knee. See if he can't get a replay of that play. Mm-hmm. might just be a bit of a cramp, the way they're prodding and probing him. Big number 99 there. Marcus Janbach. Being
Sweden's
helped up.
Three previous games he's been, not their most outstanding player on defense, he's certainly been one of them.
Sure. That'd be nice. Lance's leg.
Makes a great stop. But
twisted his ankle there, looks like a little bit. His whole leg got twisted there. Not a very pretty sight.
Brings up third and five.
Brings up third and five for the finished offense. Hand off Rakesson and again up the middle. Still on his feet, still digging. Good enough for a first down inside the 20-yard line. Marked at the 19.
Another run by
good production by the offense of Finland here.
Power running game. ISO right.
Just enough to pick up four new downs. First and 10, Finland.
Trips left, single back for Finland. Handoff to Rakesson and up the left side. Still on his feet, still digging. Inside the 10-yard line, mark him down at the 6. Good hard run, bring up first and goal for the Finns. With 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter of play.
A gain of 11. First and 10, first and goal, Finland.
Be accredited with 11-yard gain on that carry.
At about the 6.
They're marked at the 6-yard line. First and goal. Trips right, single back. Burnson calling out the send through, getting him on the same page. Burnson looking inside, throws all behind the Rotala. That would have been a perfect pass otherwise.
A little bit ago, 4 or 5 yard gain, a little bit behind the receiver this time, wasn't able to complete it.
Brings up second and goal for the Finns. Same formation. Rakesson gets the ball. He's still on his feet, still digging, still churning. Gets in near the 1-yard line. Good hard running by the running back.
Run by Matti Airaksinen. Gain of 5 yards. Third and goal at the 1-yard line.
Time this ball is snapped, they will have had the ball 8 minutes.
So we call clock control.
That's a great strategy, particularly if you score. If you don't score, sometimes it comes back to haunt you.
4 minutes, 1 second remaining in the first quarter. Third and goal for the Finnish team from the 1-yard line. I formation, fumble on the play. Looks
team
to be
Sweden
a Swedish ball.
Quarterback looked like the ball didn't quite get to the running back's stomach, looked like he set it on his hip. Check the replay, see if we can see that.
Here's a different angle. Good angle. That hole was there, coach. Just didn't have a ball in it.
I couldn't quite tell whose mistake that was. Unfortunate for Team Finland.
First and 10 for
such a fine drive.
Sweden from the 1 yard line. Hand off to Torrensen, gets them a bit of breathing room. He's out near the 10 yard line.
Great break for Team Sweden.
Five-yard game results second and five from the 9 yard line. Söderberg hands off to Torrensen around the left side, still on his feet, churning away, gets out near the 20-yard line.
Well, those two plays got him out of that deep hole.
Mark him down at the 22. Flag on the play. That flag came in late. Ball resting on the 21-yard line. Be a block in the back against the Swedes. Be a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
Like that'll make it about second and six.
Make it second and three for them, coach.
Second and three, okay. Are you looking at the box right?
Ball will be marked on the 12-yard line. Torrensen this time up the middle. Still on his feet. First down plus a little bit. Close to the 20-yard line. He's right back to where they started that, ended that last drive.
Both teams seem to be able to run the football quite well in the early part of the game. See if that could continue. See what adjustments the defenses make. Got trips this time to the wide side of the field.
So the bird rolling to his left, looking to throw. Keeps the ball and runs. Still on his feet. Hit after about a 4.5-5 yard gain.
Run by Fabian Söderberg.
They'll mark it down as a 5 yard gain.
Seven. Second and three.
Brings up second and five. So the Bug looking to throw quickly out to number seven, caught at the 30-yard line.
Very near first down.
Carl Ledeen, the receiver. We have a Finnish player down, number 20. UC Taipalma.
Injured in one of the former games a little bit. If I recall right, he came back after that injury and played
in
the game.
Up on his own power. Might have just got the wind knocked out of him there. Hope to see him back in the game. Good cornerback type almost.
That other play resulted in the first down. I wasn't sure.
Yes, it did. Ball's marked on the 31-yard line of Sweden, first and 10.
And again, Sweden sets trips to the wide side of the field.
So the bird bubble screen out to the left side, number 44, I do believe it was. Number 14, Jimmy Pallenborg.
Pass to number 14, Jimmy Pallenborg. Picks up four new downs before he's stopped by number 42, Pavel Penonen in Team Finland. First and 10.
No huddle for Sweden, still first and 10 from the 42-yard line. Sweep to the right side with Torrensen, turns the corner, still on his feet, gets close to the 49-yard line before being brought down by Ty Palma, who was in late.
Quick toss to number two, Victor Torrensen. We have a flag on that play.
That flag was aggressively thrown at the end of the play here. Have to see what it is. Looks like a block in the back by the Swedes. Not too sure about it. Offsetting penalties, unsportsmanlike conduct from offense and defense.
The extracurricular activity after the game is over.
Brings up second and four for Sweden from the 49-yard line.
Officials know this is going to be a highly contested game and trying to establish.
It's a love-hate relationship with Finland and Sweden.
They order in the game early.
Blitz coming off the Finnish side. They'll be called for offsides with contact. That'll place the ball at the 46-yard line, first and 10 for Sweden.
The offside by Juho Pietilä from Tampere University.
1 minute, 7 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. Is scoreless at Österangens EP.
Seen a very evenly played game so far, though.
Sweden in the spread formation. So the Berg looking to throw, throws it out to receiver number 81, who is untouched into the end zone. Jonathan Volgren.
Fine slant route. Nice catch. Had to go down to shoot, catch it off his shoelaces. Was able to run it in. Last 35 yards.
I almost didn't think he was going to be able to catch that ball. It was a little low thrown.
It was low. Fine catch.
Here's that. Bring that to you once again here. A little bit of an unorthodox catch, but it works for him. It works for us. Volgren untouched into the end zone. Lennius for the extra kick. Ball is up. And good. Brings us to 7. So Sweden draws first blood in this fight between Finland and Sweden.
Yep.
Game number 9 of the 2014 World University American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden.
First quarter is going to come to the end, 7-0. Sure, Team Sweden is very excited, that kind of thing, and they well should be. Team Finland's a little disappointed since they drove the ball down to the 1 yard line and turned it over. I don't expect that to curtail their efforts this next position. Just be going a different direction.
47 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play here at Österangens Idrottsplats in Uppsala, Sweden. Sweden leading over Finland 7-0. Sweden to kick off after a touchdown. Back to return for Finland is Sintu, and Rontu and Sintu, back to return. Good kick by Olenius, taken by Sintu at the 5 yard line. Brings it up the right side of the field, up back, cuts back into the middle, still on his feet, brought down finally near the 31 yard line.
Nice return.
26 yard return for the quick fin there.
He is stopped at the 31 yard line by number 24, Peter Jungstedt. First and 10, Finland.
Finland, the I formation. Slot left. Hand off to Raikkonen. Gain of about 2 yards. Bring up second and eight for the Finnish team.
Gain of 3 yards, second and seven.
Safety did a nice job of filling.
Came in and hit
that playoff.
Came in and plugged that a little bit hard. Williamson, number eight. MVP of the last game Sweden played in. And that'll bring the end of the quarter. After the first quarter, Sweden leading Finland 7-0. What do you think, Coach? We got a football game.
Yes, we do. We talked earlier in the broadcast that kicking game.
Statistics from the first
see the
quarter.
Touchdown right there. We'll finish that thought in a minute.
Of 88. Passing yards of 62,
fine catch and run there. We were talking
Finland
that the kicking game should be very
yards.
Critical and also turnovers
and
mistakes, that kind
of
thing. And that's the difference in the game so far is the turnover that Finland had at the 1 yard line.
Impressive of Sweden to turn that around and march it 99 yards down the field and put it in the end zone.
Yes, they did. Excellent turnaround by the offense once they got a hold of the ball.
Once again, I formation, second and seven for the Finnish team. A little play action. Berntsen going deep to.
A little tangled up there.
Ball intended for Heckley. We'll have two flags on the play, both in the area of a interference. See if it's offensive or defensive here. They were pushing each other around there quite a bit.
I think I know which way it's going to go.
It'll be against the defense. The defender wasn't even looking for the ball.
Pass interference. Defense number 24. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Heather Jungstedt.
15-yard penalty, but it's still probably 10 yards difference from where the penalty occurred, or as if he had caught the ball. So in that respect,
Jungstedt
maybe
credit with
that
the
terrible penalty.
Interference call. Double slot spread formation for the Finns. Hand off to Raikkonen, up the left side, still on his feet. Gets about a 5 yard gain.
Matti Eriksson makes his 11 rushing attempts. Gains 4 yards and has 45 yards.
He's been running well. He's going to have a good stat, good stats by the end of this game.
Well, this is their second possession. He's ran the ball 11 times. So sort of an indication of what Team Finland's game plan is.
Once again, an I formation slot right for the Finnish team. Hand off to the tailback, Raikkonen, and first down plus a few.
Following his big fullback into the hole.
Ruotala doing the blocking for him.
Again, it was excellent line surge on part of the Finnish offensive line.
We have a Finnish player down. It is the tailback. Number seven. Matti Raikkonen.
I'm not quite sure what the depth at this point in the tournament for Team Finland's running backs are, but that if he's unable to return, which he looks like he's walking off under his own power and in shape, so he's likely to be back in the game. But if not, that could
Matti Roski in for Matti Rakasanen. Roski is also a very good running back. Hand off to Roski up the middle, gain of 3 yards. Bring up second and seven.
We had an excellent game in the first game here, right? Matti Roski gets the ball.
Picks up a gain of 2, second and 8.
Barnson getting his play from the sideline. Trips right, single back. Looking to throw to his right side, throws out to Rotela, who gets the ball at the 30-yard line, about a yard shy of the first down.
Fine tackle. Fine tackle by the left cornerback of Team Sweden to keep him from picking up the first down.
And we have a timeout.
Timeout called by the Swedish coaches. Going in and having a little chat with their defensive unit. Looks to me as the Finnish team's found their little hole somewhere in the Swedish defense, and they're just coming at them all the time.
They have their plan. And that's basically straight ahead. Run the edge once in a while, we'll throw the edge once in a while. But we're going to run inside the tackle quite a bit of the time. Third and short, not at the 30-yard line. I would imagine they consider themselves in two-down territory. I don't know where they'd want to kick a 45 to 47-yard field goal here.
Finnish team coming back in the I formation. Rotela and Roski in the backfield. Slot left. Lead play with Roski following Rotela. Close to the first down marker. Looks to be a couple inches short from my angle.
Joshua Akina made a nice play there. Or run through.
They'll mark it.
They made about half of it.
Half a yard from the first down point. Finland electing to go for it. Once again, I formation. Hand off to the fullback, Rotela easily gets the first down. Brings up first and 10 from the 27-yard line. Finland marching towards the end zone. 9 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in the first half of the game. Sweden leading 7-0 over Finland.
Split rope to lie out again. Double slot formation. Single running back.
Barnson looking to throw, going down the middle in the seam and hitting his receiver number 12, Marcus Siskonen, for a completion inside the 5-yard line. Siskonen got hit hard on that play.
Siskonen, number 12.
Basically ran a full vertical route.
Tackled by Jakob Westlin.
Jakob Westlin with the tackle.
Inside seam opened wide up.
Siskonen on his feet, jogging off the field.
That seems like a simple route, but it's a hard one to defend.
It's also a hard one for the receiver because that free safety's coming in hard if he breaks on the proper time.
I know some defensive secondary coaches think that's where the
Rakasanen and back in the backfield again. Gets the call, gets a gain of about a yard.
It's starts your pass defense with four verticals. And we'll work back from that.
Brings up second and goal from the 2 yard line. Good to see Motti back on the field after his injury. Always love to see an offense that can switch out a tailback without losing a step. The Finns have showed us that today. I formation, handoff to Ruttila, powering his way into the end zone. With 8:07 on the clock.
Pick up 6 points for Finland, 7-6.
Excuse me, 8:11 remaining on the clock.
Their tailbacks are their feature backs in their offense. I like they need a hard yard. Number 32 is going to get
I like the fact the quarterback is also the place kicker. Barnson for the extra point. Snap is out, kick is up, and wide left. It's a one-point game so far, Coach. 7-6, so Sweden over Finland. 8 minutes, 11 remaining in the first half of game.
Those extra point field goal teams are certainly part of the special team units that have to perform, and that could develop into a big play as the game goes along. We'll see.
That's exactly what we were talking about before the game and in the pregame up to the start. The special teams will have a key role in today's game. I just hope that missed field goal doesn't come back to haunt the Finnish team.
Well, it all depends on your point of view. Team Sweden, then you hope that it is a complication. Team Finland, well, then you hope just as you say.
10 plays and a total yardage of 69 for the touchdown.
Return team on the field for Sweden with Hampus Hellemark in the middle, Torsen on the left side, and Jonathan Volgen on the left. Berntsen looking to kick from the 35. Kick is to the side of Jonathan Volgen. It'll go out of bounds at the got a cameraman taken out there.
I believe the flag is for kicking out of bounds.
Yes, it is. Not for hitting the cameraman,
not
no.
Not for running into the cameraman, which it kind of looked like.
Ball is out of bounds at the 23-yard line.
Receiving team can have a re-kick the 30 or take the ball at their own 35. Whatever the coach's choice.
I believe the Coach Billgren might want them to re-kick this one. In the hopes of getting a little bit better field position than the 35.
At least the return team staying on the field, so I think that's a pretty good indication.
Kick out no bounds.
They'll move it back to the 30 and kick it again.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Defense, number 6. Targeting. Number 6 has ejected himself from the game.
We got a spearing call against the Hampus Hellemark.
15-yard penalty. Free kick.
So that ball will be placed on the 45-yard line for the kick. And the big running back of Sweden has been ejected.
I'm a little confused.
We'll have to get a replay of that to see if we can take a look at it again. Been called for targeting, which back in my day was called spearing. Leading with their helmet. We'll take a look at it after the kickoff here.
I saw one flag on the field. That's why I'm on the field.
I saw the two on the sideline, and that was it. Kick is once again towards the sideline where Volgren takes it on a bobble, changes direction, then comes back to the sideline once again and is brought down at the 20-yard line. Got flags flying once again coming in. It's a yellow rain.
Targeting.
Take a look at the replay of the first kickoff. Hellemark coming in from the sideline. Shoulder to shoulder. That doesn't warrant a flag from my view, Coach.
Well.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Kicking team number 12. Unnecessary roughness. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run.
Well, Sweden starts at the 35.
I think the officials are trying to be very, very assertive and trying to establish order in the game. Not that I see the players out of line all that much. I do think the call was a questionable call, although he did have his head down. I don't know that he was head-to-head contact, but
I think they're calling for targeting an unprotected player, Coach. Torreson on a swing pass. Gain of about 3 yards.
I guess I think if you're covering a kickoff, you shouldn't be unprotected.
No.
It's not like you're coming over the middle looking back to catch a pass.
Good swing pass by the offense of Sweden out to Torreson. Gain of 3 yards. Pitch to the left to Torreson. Turns left corner, hit hard at the 40-yard line, brought down finally at the 48.
Good hard run. Run through the tackle, another 2 or 3 yards. Those kinds of plays and efforts get a sideline excited.
Number two, Victor Torreson from the Gävle Red Devils organization. Trips right, Sutherberg hands off to Torreson up the middle. A little bit of a inside zone play there, close to the 50-yard line for first down. Quite a large crowd here today, Coach.
Yeah, that offset fullback comes, blocks back, can help the cutback.
Trips right for Sweden. Torreson the single back. Looking to throw with Sutherberg. Puts it across the middle to Adine, who is near the first down marker. They'll mark him just a little bit shy of it.
Pass to number 7, Carl Adine of Team Hugh Gordon in Sweden. For a gain of 9 before he's stopped by number 9, Antero Kivinen, 2nd and 1.
Staying with the trips right, single back, Swedish offense. Swing pitch to Torreson around the right side, first down, plus a yard or two.
Run by Victor Torreson, picks up 2 yards, and 1st and 10, Sweden.
5 minutes, 52 seconds remaining in the first half of play here at the 2014 World University American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden.
Tailback change.
Johannes Nilsson in that tailback. Sutherberg throws out to his left side to number 14. Jimmy Palmborg for a 4-yard gain, bring up 2nd and 6.
Number 42 in Team Finland. Gain of 4, 2nd and 6.
So the bird rolls his right, looking to throw the ball, finally gets the ball out, and open is Volgren, who makes a beautiful catch. Brought down near the 2 yard line.
I thought Fabian was going to wait too long to throw it.
I didn't think he'd get that one out there.
I think he may have been fighting the grip on the ball. I don't know, but as he was rolling, looked like he took a little more time than.
Take another look at it here. He had good pressure coming from the linebacker. Took a shot after the hit, after the pass. Volgren, a phenomenal catch. Hanged on to the ball. Looks like Volgren got a bit of a Charlie horse on the play.
We've had basically two teams running at each other, but Team Sweden's has made two large or two big passing plays. It's kind of the difference in the game right now.
First and goal from the 2 yard line for Sweden.
So we have first and goal at the 3 yard line.
See if Team Sweden gets in any kind of a heavier set. They don't. We got trips to the left. Ball's pretty much in the middle of the field.
Johannes Nielsen, timeout called by the quarterback, Fabian Söderberg. Wasn't happy with what he saw. Good impressive drive by the Swedes after all the penalties with the kicks. And the unfortunate ejection of Hampus Hellemark, number 6.
Good possession. Good possession. That was a big play. Keep the secondary loosened up a little bit. Keep them from collapsing down on a run. Although Team Finland's free safety when they're in the cover three look has not been cheating down much, I haven't thought.
Söderberg and company once again on the field. Trips left, single back is Johannes Nielsen. First and goal from the 2 yard line. Söderberg looking to throw, decides to keep the ball himself, gets about a yard gain. If that.
Run by Fabian Söderberg. He stopped by number 77.
They'll mark it at no gain, bring up second down.
Gain about 1 yard, second and goal at 2 yard line.
Second and two, spread formation. Hand off to Johannes Nielsen. No, excuse me, faked me out. Söderberg kept the ball himself and switched directions to the left side, ran it in untouched.
Nice play.
A little bit of a quarterback read there.
Read it very well. In, collapsed down the line of scrimmage, pulled the ball, went in, untouched.
Elenius in for the extra point. Kick is up. And good. Brings us to 14-6. Sweden over Finland with 3 minutes 39 seconds remaining in the first half of game. Been impressive drives by both offenses here. Good mix and matchup of the play calls by the offensive coordinator of the Swedish team. A little bit of run, a little bit of pass, put you in the end zone.
Finland went down and answered the last score that Sweden makes. See how they answer this time.
Kick to the left side, it'll bounce out of bounds near the 20-yard line. Flag coming in late there. Don't know if he's marking it for the
he's
kick out of bounds.
Throwing the flag for the delay of game call. Team Finland is employing the same offensive set they have.
High formation, handoff to Rakkisanen up the left side, still on his feet, still churning away, close to the first fumble, recovered by Finland.
Extra effort, got his body turned around and was able to, the ball was more apt to come out when you get turned around and you're got your back facing the defenders as opposed to your chest and shoulders.
Good heads up by Siskinen there to get on the ball.
Certainly can't blame the running back for his effort. Rotala split out again in the trips.
Swing pass out to Rakkisanen and missed tackle. First down for the Finns at the 47-yard line. First and 10 from the 47-yard line for Finland. Trips left formation, single back is Rakkisanen. Handoff up the middle, gain of 3 yards. Mark him down at the 49.5-yard line of Sweden. 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half of play. At the halftime break, we'll try to get the Swedish quarterback Fabian Söderberg in for an interview. Berntsen looking to throw the ball, throwing it deep down the left side, covered well through the hands of Heckley. If he caught that, it was a touchdown, Coach.
I think he lost sight of it just as it went over the defender.
Hit him square in the hands, but he couldn't get a grasp on it. Another angle here. Bit of a pump fake from Berntsen. Third down and 7 for the Finnish team from the 49-yard line. Berntsen looking to throw once again. Lots of time to pass down the middle through the hands of Rotila.
Brings up our first punting situation of the day.
Brings up a fourth down situation for the Finnish offense from the Swedish 49-yard line. See if they'll go for it or bring the punting team on.
1:44 left in the game.
Timeout called by Finland with 1:44 remaining in the game. As I said earlier, we'll try to get Swedish quarterback Fabian Söderberg on camera for you at halftime, get a couple words and questions at him.
I would say by the looks of their huddle that Team Finland is going to go for it. I'm not sure I would choose to do that at this point in time, being a one-score game. But nobody asked me to be the Finland coach either.
Well, the way Sweden's playing their offense, minute and 30 seconds is an eternity almost. They should be able to get off a couple of big plays.
They may have a play, Team Finland may have a play that they think they can certainly successfully complete the 6.5 to 7 yards they need for the first down.
Burnson staying under center, trips left, single back. Looking to throw once again. Under pressure, keeps the ball this time, runs it around the outside. Still inbounds, gets out of bounds near the 44-yard line. They'll mark him out at the 45, not quite enough for the first down.
Quarterback needs to know where the sticks are. Don't know why you run out of bounds there, being short of the stick.
First and 10 for Sweden from their own 45-yard line. Söderberg rolling to his right, looking to throw. Going deep down the sideline, over the head of Carl Adin, who was well defended off that sideline.
Double slot formation.
Söderberg, quick pitch out to Torrensen. Looking to turn the corner, finally gets around the corner. Crosses the 50-yard line near the 46-yard line. Inbounds, they'll mark him down. Clock will keep rolling at 1:15. Brings up third down and one to go.
Sweden has one timeout left.
Söderberg keeps it, calls his own number, gets the first down. That'll stop the clock with 52 seconds remaining in the first half. Spread formation for Söderberg. Looking to pass. Going down the right sideline. Through the hands of a defender, almost intercepted by number 20. UC Tai Palma.
Almost picked off by UC Tai Palma, number 20 of Team Finland. Second down and 10.
Stopping the clock with 30 seconds remaining in the first half of play. Sweden leading 14-6 over Finland. Looking to score once again in the last 30 seconds before the half is Sweden. Söderberg dropping once again to pass the ball, looking down the left side this time, through the hands of a little bit high for receiver number 84. Eric Body, the intended receiver. Bringing up third and 10 for the Swedes with 26 seconds remaining on the clock. A little bit of a play action, middle screen to Torreson. Still on the run, heading for the sideline, out of bounds after the first down marker. Good heads up by the running back. 18 seconds remaining in the first half of play. First and 10 from the
32-yard
line.
32-3.
Enough time on the clock to get about three plays off if the Swedes are quick about it. Southernberg looking to throw once again down the middle of the field. Open is Adine, almost picked off by number 7 of the Finns.
He was open for a little bit.
Matti Rakkisenen. We have a flag in the area of a hold on the field.
Maybe offensive holding.
It'll be a unnecessary roughness call.
That's a huge penalty.
15 yards, they'll march into finished territory.
11 seconds.
Placing the ball at the 17-yard line. First and 10 for the Swedes.
Take a shot at it, call timeout, go for the field goal, or perhaps if you want to really roll the dice, maybe two shots.
Chinese contingent hollering for their Swedish compatriots on the field. Spread formation, single back is Torreson. Southernberg looking to throw once again down the left side over the hands of his intended receiver, number 84. Body.
Don't look like they're bringing out the field goal unit, so.
Second down, 10 yards to go for a first down. 7 seconds remaining in the first half of play. So the Berg looking to throw once again, tucks the ball down and decides to run around the left side. Brought down finally. Inside the 15-yard line, trying to signal for timeout, but the clock had ran down. See how the referees call this one, if he called a timeout or is down. They're going to say he's got a second left on the clock, I do believe. Nope, they'll call that the end of the half, I do believe.
The time elapsed during the last play, halftime.
They'll call that halftime by the referees.
I thought that was going to be a very generous award for Team Sweden if they let them kick it.
Going into the half, Sweden leading Finland 14-6. See if we get the Swedish quarterback Fabian Söderberg on the camera so we can have a few questions with him.
Interpool restaurant tent in halftime to get food and beverage. You can also buy supporter items from this first World University Championship in the tent by the Interpool tent.
And that brings the end of the first half of the game number 9 of the 2014 World University of American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden. We'll bring you Mr. Sutherberg here in a couple seconds. We'll shortly bring you Fabian Sutherberg here.
Yeah, I'm right here.
Okay, Fabian.
Yeah, hey,
good
coach.
Good first half of the game there.
Thanks,
coach. Looked impressive play calling from the offensive coordinator there. Little run, little pass, mix it up a little bit.
Yeah.
Unfortunate to lose Hampus Hellemark on a penalty there.
Yeah, he's a good player. He didn't start today, but obviously we would have needed him throughout the whole game. But unfortunately, you know, he was too excited, did something stupid. But you know, referee, they make the call, so it was unfortunate for us.
Let Coach Kersley here give you a couple questions.
Yeah, sure.
Bobby, and this is Coach Kersley up here in the box. As my partner here indicated, the games went very well for you guys so far. Your offensive line seems to be doing a great job. Running back's doing a great job, and you're mixing in some passes as well.
Yeah.
And was your game plan to come in and run the ball primarily at the guys, or how's that go?
You know, we just went in to this game doing everything with confidence, mix it up, you know, make the defense confused. We knew their linebackers were a couple yards off behind the line of scrimmage, so we knew we could run the ball. And as you've seen, we've done some quarterback keepers to get some short yardage, some first downs. But
well, I'll be interested to see, you know, what adjustments the defenses make at halftime, that kind of thing, and I'm sure you will too. And we don't want to keep you out here very long. We want to let you get in and get with your teammates and your coaching staff and see what adjustments you guys want to make. We want to wish you a lot of luck in the second half, and way to hang in there and throw the football.
All right, thanks, Coach.
One last question for you there, Fabian.
Mm-hmm.
Your guess on the game tomorrow?
My guess on the game tomorrow?
Yes.
Oh, man, it's a tough one. They're both great teams. It's up to the – pretty much up to the coaches' game plan. You know, they're disciplined teams. I think I give a little heads up on Japan, Team Japan.
Okay. Good deal. Get back to your coaches.
All right, thanks, Coach. Take it easy.
That was Fabian Sutherberg there. That brings the end of our sending for the first half. We'll show you a bit of a replay of the first half, and we'll leave it at that. And stay tuned for the second half in roughly 12 minutes. Thank you for that. Welcome back to Uppsala, Sweden for the second half of game number 9 of the 2014 World University of American Football Championships. Our broadcast today is brought to you by Here Landslaget. The score is 14-6. Sweden over Finland. Had an exciting first half of football. Lots of run plays by both Finland and Sweden. Big drives. Sweden out on top.
Sweden will be receiving the opening kickoff of the second half. I'll be interested in, as I said to Fabian Soderberg there at the end of the half, what adjustments the defensive coordinators make. They may, not that there was terrible defense or anything like that, they may not make any adjustments.
The Finns need to do something to stop the passing game of Sweden. They adjust a little bit in the second half there, broke up a couple of plays.
Actually, on that first catch and run, the 35-yard run, the safety was just a little slow getting to the middle part of the field. Other than that, no major breakdowns.
Back to return is Torrensen and Williamson. Burnson's kick is a short kick. It'll bounce one time, taken by the up back. Number 24 of Sweden. Heather Jungstedt on the return. Brought the ball back out to the 31-yard line. Excuse me, 32-yard line, they'll mark it at. First and 10 for Sweden's offense. See if they pick up where they left off in the first half.
Double slot formation.
Johannes Nielsen is the single back. So the bird hands off to Nielsen. Up the left side, still on his feet. Power running out to the 45-yard line. Almost looked like he took Fabian with him on that handoff.
Yeah, the outside backers were coming on that one.
First and 10 from the 46-yard line.
Cover two look here, double slot.
Southerner looking to throw a quick pass out to the outside. Dropped by number 14.
Receiver looked up.
Palmbord.
Right as the ball got to his hands.
Second down and 10.
Trips right for Sweden. Quick pitch out to Johannes Nielsen. Turns the corner. Over the 50-yard line. Hit out of bounds at the 45. They'll mark him 1 yard short of the first down. Brings up third and one for Sweden. Good hard run by Nielsen there. Another angle of it. Trips left for Sweden. Blitz coming from the Finns, but not quick enough to stop Söderberg from calling his own number straight up the middle. Good blocking by the offensive line. That center shot out of there about 10 yards, coach. Spread formation. Hits left to Johannes Nielsen. Flag coming in. Still on his feet. Close to the first down.
Not a good run by Johannes Nielsen. We're again about 10, but we have a flag on the play.
Tailback runs hard, runs with his shoulders down. Good body lean.
Chop block, offense number 56, a 78, 15 yards penalty.
Big Daniel Soderberg being called for a chop block on the line. For those of you that are unfamiliar with American football, if one offensive lineman has contact with another, the other cannot lay a cut block on him. Otherwise, it'll be called a chop.
That's a big. That's about a 25-yard penalty in effect. We'll fight a 10 to 11-yard run with a 15-yard penalty on top of it.
So the bird back to throw, throws out to his receiver, Ulenius. Gets the ball inside of Finnish territory at the 47.
Got 10 yards of those 25 back.
Pavel Penanen. Been a good job defensively so far.
Penanen credited with the tackle on the play. Trips right for Sweden. Soderberg rolling to his right, looking to throw. Goes back to his left side. Deep down the field, over the head of the receiver, Valgren.
Pass intended for Jonathan Valgren, number 81.
I think his receiver changed routes to midstream.
The ball was about 10 yards ahead of Olgan.
Double slot formation. Black cover two, secondary coverage.
So the Berg dropping back. Looking to throw once again down the middle. Complete to number 81. Out at the first down marker at the 32-yard line. Jonathan Volgren, the receiver.
He did a nice job of finding a soft spot.
We got a flag in the backfield.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense number 85, 15-yard penalty.
We'll march off a 15-yarder at the end of the play.
I think we've had more flags in this game than we had all the other put together.
I do believe you're right there, Coach.
Been very few flags.
Number 95.
Penalty called against Mikko Rastas. On the Finnish defense.
By number 95, Mikko Rastas of the National Defense University. Leads to a first and 10.
Brings up first and 10 from the 17-yard line.
Like we've got a cover three now.
Spread formation. Hand off to Nielsen faked and ball thrown to number 84. Brought down inside the 5-yard line.
Pass to number 84,
Erik Bari, the receiver. Trips left for Sweden. Torsen in the backfield. Pitch to Torsen on the right side. Tripped up at the 5-yard line. Be marked down to the loss. Bring up second and 4 yards of the goal line. Second and goal, Sweden from the 4.
The play has worked good when they're in the trips formation and the secondary stays in cover two. They had more defenders on the edge that time than they've been having. Now we got trips. It looks like it's either cover three or man, probably man. Corners look like they're covering man.
Hand off to Torsen. Gets close to the goal line. They'll mark him down about a yard and a half, 2 yards from the goal.
Run by number two, Victor Torsen.
Brings up third and goal for Sweden.
For a gain about a yard. Third and goal.
Have a Timeout called on the field.
Finland
timeout.
That'll
be their first timeout of the half. 7:50 remaining in the third quarter of play. Sweden leading 14-6 over Finland.
It's a big play for Team Finland. They don't want to fall behind at least two touchdowns.
Good offensive drive by the Swedes. Finland starting the tournament, 24 players. I do believe they're down to around 21.
I think they'll probably have somebody assigned to the quarterback. Looks like Team Sweden's in a two-back set.
Split backs, handoff to Torreson. Goes unmolested into the end zone.
Nice call by them. Team Sweden, nice call by their offensive coaching staff.
Scores the touchdown on that 1 yard run. And then we now have a Sweden lead.
Good lead block by number five, Boklund. Valenius for the extra point. Kick is up and through the uprights. Good. He's 3 for 3 on the day. Brings us to 21. 7:46 remaining in the third quarter. The score is 21-6. Sweden over Finland.
Well, Sweden takes the opening kickoff and goes right down the field. Nice drive of runs and passes. Overcame a large setback. Lost 25 yards of field position, overcame that.
Heckley and Sin to be back to return. Bit of a short kick, taken by Sinter at the 10-yard line. Straight up the field, tackled finally by Johannes Nielsen and company at the 28-yard line.
That's the second tackle Johannes has made on the kickoff.
Namu Sinu, 21, in Finland. He's stopped by the running backs in Team Sweden, Victor Thoresson and Johannes Nielsen.
Both running backs, Torreson and Nielsen, credited with the tackle on the return. Here comes Team Finland. I formation. Hand off to Rakkisenen. Still on his feet. Getting forced backwards after a gain of 5 yards, 4 yards.
Run by Matti Airaksonen in Finland. For a gain of 6, second down and 4.
Free safety coming off, looks hanging his arm a little. Perhaps a stinger.
Williamson being looked after on the sideline.
I don't think he's very comfortable right now.
Trips left single back for Finland. Rotala at the slot position. Looking to throw is Berntsen. Decides to tuck it and run, gets the first down, flag in the backfield.
Thrown by the umpire, which usually results in offensive holding. Perhaps an illegal hand to the face.
Holding on number 65, the offense. Hannes Mattila. Brings up second and 15 for the Finnish offense. A little bit of a misdirection in the backfield, given their own to Rotala, excuse me.
Number 32, Henry Rotala. Stopped by Joshua Kiema, number 20 in Team Sweden.
It'll bring up third and 13. Barnson looking to throw. Puts the ball out to his left side. Intended for Heckley. Well defended by number 24. A flag in the backfield.
Got a late flag in the backfield.
Flag on the play.
Could be a personal foul. It was well after the game. It appeared to be well after the play was over.
Conduct. Defense number 25. 15 yard penalty.
Penalty against Matthias Liljestrand, a personal foul, unsportsmanlike conduct.
That's a big penalty. They had him stopped. It's going to result in a first down.
Liljestrand, an Uppsala player, playing left end.
Unfortunate mistake there.
Giving the Finns first and 10 from the 43-yard line. Hand off to Rakesinen, who slips the tackle but gets chased down by Joshua Kenna. Good hustle by Joshua there.
Stopped by Joshua Kenna, but we have a flag.
We have another flag on the field near the 48-yard line.
Unless it was after the play was over. Loss of about almost 10 yards.
Illegal blocking below the waist. Offense number 11. Penalty declined. Second down.
Penalty will be declined. A low block. Play clock down to 16. Second and 15. Burnson throws out to Rotala through his hands.
Pass to Henry Rotala, incomplete.
Bring up third and, excuse me, third and 17. 19.
Long ways. Whatever.
Yeah, third, we'll just say third and long, Coach.
Third and longer than normal.
After the rain we've had, some of the lines on the field have dimmed, have been blotted out a little bit.
I would look for him to go to number 11.
Burnson looking to throw once again, going downfield. Intended for Heckley at the 50-yard line. Defended well. brings up fourth and long for the Finnish team. The punt team will come on. Whistles blown by the officials.
Seems to be some confusion on the punt return unit by Team Sweden. Several guys going on late. Some coming off late.
Sweden's first time out of the half. 2 many people on the field weren't getting off fast enough. After the timeout, we've got the return team on the field. Williamson is back in the field after his stinger. Back to return.
Yeah, I noticed that he went back on. Tough kid.
Cheerleading squad, the Phantoms from the Uppsala 86ers. Today's game sponsor is Hyreslandslaget.
Burnson once again back to do the kicking. Low snap. Blocked by Sweden. Rolling towards the 20-yard line. Picked up by Bari. Advanced for another 5 yards.
The punt is blocked. And recovered by number 84.
They'll mark it down at the 10-yard line. Or just shy of the 10-yard line.
Starting at the 10-yard line. First goal.
I do believe we'll credit Joshua Kennett with that block.
He was certainly pretty excited coming off the field, at least. If that's any indication.
He's up first and 10 from the 10 and a half yard line. Söderberg calls his own number, takes it up the middle.
Run by Fabian Söderberg.
Gets a gain of roughly four.
1 yard, second and goal.
He's done a nice job of running the offense today for no more time than he's been able to spend a quarterback.
He brings up second and 7 for the Swedes. Söderberg looking to throw, throws to the outside, complete to Torreson. Into the end zone, touchdown Sweden. Brings us to 27. Scores Sweden 27, Finland 6 with 4:13 remaining in the third quarter.
So far in this game, catches the ball and runs to the end zone for a gain of 6 points for Sweden.
Extra point is good.
Extra point attempt.
Elenius is 4 for 4 on the day.
Big play.
28-6 is the score. 4:13 remaining in the third quarter.
somewhat hesitant to mention the fact that the blocked punt
that drive was 10 yards
resulted in that touchdown, but obviously it did.
Special
teams, because
again,
we had talked so much about special teams may come into play in big ball games.
A lot thanks to hitting body number 84, who first blocked the punt and then recovered it to get Sweden into a great field position.
See if they have somebody try to block number 39 this time.
By the way, Johannes Nielsen is going down the field. I think he's just more or less steamrolling people before he gets in on a tackle. Keep my eye on him here for a minute. Elenius' kick is high in to Heckley at the 10-yard line. Heckley still on his feet. Moving downfield, gets close to the 36-yard line.
Kickoff goes to number 11.
Brought down by number 44 of Sweden, Anton Holmberg.
From Försvarshögskolan at the 36-yard line.
One of the better athletes on the field.
Finland takes over roughly where they ended their last drive. After a good return by Heckley.
Wasn't much false movement on his part. Hit it upfield.
Eye formation for the Finns. Looking to throw out to the flat is Burnson, who hits Rotala, gets a gain of about 4 yards.
Number 32, Henry Rotala, picks up a gain of 5 before he's stopped by number 20, Joshua Akena from Uppsala University.
Second and 6 for Finland. Hand off to Rakkisanen, who's brought down in the backfield.
Number 95 got a great charge off the ball.
They'll mark that as a loss of 3 yards. Bringing up 3rd and 8.
Tackled for a loss by Jesper Grossman and Kenneth Brickley.
Jesper Grossman from Uppsala University on the tackle. Burnson looking to throw down the right sideline to Heckley, complete at the 40-yard line. 1st and 10 for Finland in Swedish territory.
That's about the match and a good catch by Marcus Heckley. For a gain of 20 yards, 1st and 10.
20-yard gain by the Finnish offense.
At the 42-yard line.
1st and 10 from the 42. 2:37 remaining in the third quarter. High formation once again for the Finns. Looking to throw Burnson down the right side once again to Heckley. One hand catch with the defender on him. Beautifully caught ball. Kind of like baseball, tie goes to the receiver, as in tie goes to the runner. When both the defender and offensive player come down with the ball.
We're going to see more of that as the game goes on.
Replay of that. One-handed
catch by Marcus Heckley, who wraps his arms around Jakob Deslien in Team Sweden and still catches the ball.
First and 10 from the 15. From the 15. Run play by the Finns.
Run by Matti Araksinen.
Matti Araksinen.
Number 7. Stopped by Kenneth Pankler, number 95 in Sweden.
A gain of a yard and a half on the play. Brings up 2nd and 8.
2nd down and 9.
Trips left for Finland, single back, looking to throw out in the flat. That's
get
a live
ball.
Ball.
Get on the ball.
Sweden recovers. Referee was pointing in the direction of Sweden. That was a backwards
that
pass.
That play is ruled as an incomplete pass. Third down and 9.
Well, from my angle up here, it looked like it was going backwards.
If I had to make the ruling from here, I would agree with you. But that's why they're there, right?
We're not wearing striped shirts, no sir. That'll bring up 3rd down and 8 for the Finnish offense. Burnson looking to throw once again and going down the middle of the field through the hands of the defender. Incomplete. Bring up 4th down. Flag on the field.
Incomplete pass intended for Markus Siskonen.
Pass intended for Siskonen. Broken up by number 21 of Sweden.
Illegal man down.
Lovenberg.
Down.
Illegal man downfield is a penalty. It'll be declined. It'll bring up 4th down and 8
that
for Finland.
Finland's got 4th down and 9. And it looks like they're going for it.
I probably should know this, but I feel that they would have accepted the penalty. It had just been a 5-yard penalty, and there would still been a loss of downs. Sweden would have gained 5 yards of field position. They take the penalty.
I'm not too sure on that point myself. Trips left for Finland. Looking to throw is Burnson. Flag coming in once again. Be against the defense.
Scrambling.
Throws the ball into the end zone. Nobody comes down with it.
Incomplete pass intended for number 21, Namusinu. And we have
looks to be a holding flag. Ball will be turned over on downs by Finland. It's the 2nd time they've been in the red zone and haven't converted.
We have turnover on downs, and Sweden will start their offense first.
A little bit better field position on this one than the first one.
Yes,
for the Swedes. Instead of starting from the 1-yard line, they'll be starting from the 15.
Sweden has changed quarterbacks.
Nielsen in the quarterback. Keeps it up for himself after a read. Brought down for a 1-yard loss. Although give it a 1-yard gain, excuse me.
for a gain of about 1 yard. Second down and nine.
Brings up second and nine for Sweden.
Even though Sweden has changed quarterbacks, Soderberg is not out of the game. He's now playing the wide receiver.
Nielsen pitched the left to number five, who fumbles the ball, still loose. Looks to me as if a Finnish player is on it. No, a Swedish player comes up with it. Fabian Söderberg came up with that fumble recovery.
Number five, Jonathan Boklund, recovered
after
by
Boklund's fumble.
We have a third and long, Sweden.
Good hustle by the quarterback.
I couldn't see Fabian, but I thought it must be a Swedish ball, or the Finnish sideline would have been a little more excited than it was.
We have the end of the third quarter.
That brings the end of the third quarter of play.
To Sweden.
Scores 28-6, Sweden over Finland, with 12 minutes remaining in the game.
12 minutes to go of the game.
Put you on the payroll.
Nothing like getting something sweet to eat off a cute girl. Third down and 14 for Sweden. Nielsen looking to throw, gets the ball out. Complete to number 14 of Sweden.
Number 14,
Jimmy Palmborg.
Advances to the 30-yard line, or 28-yard line. First and 10, Sweden.
First and 10, Sweden. From the 29-yard line. Nielsen looking to throw once again. Throws it out to Torsen on the swing pass. Gets a gain of about 6 yards.
Good first down play.
Bring up second and four.
Ball goes to number two, Victor Tunesson.
Keeps the clock moving.
For gain of
which is
in seven. Second
Sweden's interest
three.
At this point in time.
Nielsen pitches back to Johannes Nielsen, flag in the backfield. Close to the first down marker is Johannes.
We may have a hold on number 78.
And we have a flag on the play.
Holding, offense number 78, 10-yard penalty.
Holding call against Big Daniel Söderberg on the right side. Well, marks the ball back 5 yards, or 10 yards, excuse me. Brings up second and 14 for Sweden. Nielsen looking to throw. A little bit of a screen pass there to Nielsen. Still on his feet, chugging away. Gets close to the 35-yard line. Another flag coming in late.
And a flag is thrown by linesman Johan Blomberg.
Legal block below the waist by Anton Linnaeus.
Correction. Penalty is
half the distance to the goal.
Brings up a penalty of half the distance to the goal line. Bring up a second and very long for Sweden. From the 14-yard line. Looks to be about a second and 25 for Sweden. Nielsen back to pass, throws out to Sutherberg on the left side. Gets near the 20-yard line. Gain of 6 yards.
Throw from Joachim Nielsen goes to Fabian Sutherberg. For gain about 4 yards. Third and long.
Brings up a third and 19 for Sweden. Nielsen looking to throw once again. Going down the middle of the field to Sutherberg near the 45-yard line, but a little bit too high for Fabian to get up and catch.
Fourth and long, Sweden brings in the punt team.
Which will bring the punt team on the field. First time we've seen the Swedish punt team today. Punt is up, a high good kick. The bounce around the 45, gets a Swedish bounce. Be downed at the 44-yard line.
Punt goes to the 44-yard line. And Sebastian Bernstrom, the quarterback from Norvia University of Applied Sciences, will start the Finland offense, first and 10.
Finland in good field position after the punt. 9:48 remaining in the final quarter of the game. Score is 28-6. Sweden over Finland. I formation, handoff to Rakusinen. Gets a gain of about 8 yards on the play.
Run by number 7, Matti Airaksinen. For a gain of 6, second down and 4.
Finland still has time, but they almost need to score on this possession.
Second and 3 for Finland from the 47-yard line. Hand off up the middle to Roski, inside the 20 to the 15. They'll mark him down at the 17-yard line.
He was close to scoring.
Came out of the backfield like a shot, he did. Good run by Roski. Spread formation, Roski single back. Burnson looking to throw, quick pass out to Heckley. Short of the first down marker.
Lucky meet about 8.
But downed at the 13-yard line.
Pass to Marcus Heckley, number 11.
He's pretty effective on a hitch route because he's got behind the secondary 3 or 4
down,
times today.
Second and 5 for the Finns. Hand off to Roski. Stopped dead at the line of scrimmage.
Kineski for no gain.
They'll mark that as a 1 yard gain.
Gain of 1 yard.
Brings up third and four. Burnson looking to throw once again, throws out complete to number 12, Siskinen.
We're going to mark him short.
Brings up a fourth and about a yard. Now they call it incomplete.
Fourth down, Finland.
Huh. Interesting. Remains at fourth and four for Finland. Burnson looking to throw once again, puts the ball in the area of Heckley, who's holding his ankle after he fell down.
Pass incomplete.
I think his ankle gave out when he went to plant and cut.
Sweden will start their offense at the 17-yard line.
Brings up first and 10 for Sweden from their own 17. Excuse me, own 13. Run play by Boklund up the left side. Good for 9 yards. Second and one. ...28-6 with 6:19 remaining in the final quarter of play. Quarterback Reed and hand off to Boklund once again. Good enough for a first down. First down is signaled. Change will move. First and 10, Sweden from the 24. Nielsen pitch out to Boklund on the right side, turns a corner, gets a few yards and still going and out of bounds near the 30-yard line.
Run by number 5, Jonathan Boklund from Arlanda. For a gain of 6.
Marked him down as a
second down,
5-yard gain at the 29-yard line. Nielsen dropping back to throw, puts the ball out to the right side, up in the air to catch it is number 4, 14. Paul Borg on the reception near the 40-yard line. He'll mark him down at the 41.
Pass to Ian Paul Borg, complete.
More yellow laundry.
A lot of yellow rags on the field. Once again, Sweden called for a chop block.
Correction, second down.
They'll be penalized on that one.
A little unusual on pass protection.
10-yard penalty, bring up second and 15-yard penalty. Bring up second and 24. Nielsen looking to throw from the 14th. Complete to Soderberg, who is brought down at the 21-yard line.
Ball to Fabian Soderberg.
Gets back about 7 yards. Brings up third down and 13.
10 yards.
I wonder if they're trying to set up a double pass sometime.
Third and long.
Wouldn't surprise me with Leo Bilgren. He's well known for razzle dazzle plays. Nielsen back to throw under pressure. Run down from behind, but they didn't bring him down. Nielsen gets the ball out. Complete to receiver near the 40, advances to the 48. Torreson on the reception.
Looking for open receivers. And he finds Victor Torreson.
Looked to me as if the Finnish defense had him, but he squirreled his way out of that one.
When the quarterback breaks contain, usually good things happen for the offense and not so good of things happen for the defense.
Good block by Soderberg at the end of the play there. To help Torreson get an extra 5 yards after the reception. Nielsen pitches back to Boklund. Around the left side, who is hit at the line of scrimmage and will be no gain on the play.
Ball goes to number 5, Jonathan Boklund, for no gain, second down and 10.
Clock continues to run.
2:42 remaining in the final quarter of play here in Uppsala, Sweden. The score is 28-6, Sweden over Finland. Swedish offense waiting for the play to be called from the sideline. Four different coaches giving four different signals all at the same time.
6 seconds, they're gonna have to hurry just a bit. 2-1.
Gets the snap off. Hand off to Johannes Nielsen up the middle for a gain of about 4 yards. They'll mark him down as a 3-yard gain. Brings up 3rd and 7 for Sweden.
Ball goes to number 39, Johannes Nilsson, for a gain of 3.
It's been a great drive here for Team Sweden. Taking lots of valuable time off the clock.
We're inside the 2-minute barrier at 1:48. Clock is ticking. Sweden leading 28-6 over Finland. Without a major catastrophe and timeout called by Finland. Without a major catastrophe here, I don't think Finland will score again in this game.
No, but I'm not quite sure why they let the clock run down to 14 seconds. They were going to call a timeout.
And we welcome the cheerleading squad, the Phantoms.
Yeah, if we were to throw a MVP vote of ourselves, for the Finnish side, Matti Rakkinen has got my vote. Tailback had a lot of gains.
Either he or their fine receiver, number 11.
Both, or Heckley, yeah.
Both have had a good game. Fabian, I think, would get my vote.
On the Swedish side, Fabian Soderberg would get my vote as well. 1 minute 35 seconds remaining in today's game between Sweden and Finland. Finland has 6 points to Sweden's 28. Third and seven for Sweden from midfield.
Well,
flags everywhere, a false start on the offense.
That wasn't a vote for Fabian there.
Quarterback slash receiver Fabian Sutherberg called for the false start. As you see in the replay, putting his hands on his head and weeping.
All wide receivers, when they false start, know what the coaches always tell them. Look at the ball.
Nielsen looking to screen pass to Nielsen. No gain.
Screen pass to number 39, Johannes Nielsen. Brought down hard by Mikko Rastas.
Rastas on the attack. University.
Timeout, Finland. Timeout, Finland. Finland's last timeout. And once again, the cheerleading squad, the Phantoms.
One minute, 25 seconds remaining in the final quarter of the game. Game number 9 of the 2014 World University American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden. Good picture of our cheerleaders there on the sideline. Pretty ladies. Been here in all sorts of weather, cold, snow, rain, blow. Fourth
Show
down.
Must go on, right?
Punting team on the field. Snap is back, kick is up. High short kick. Come down around the 40-yard line. Gets a Swedish bounce. Or Finnish bounce, excuse me.
Resulted in a 4-yard punt.
Be downed at the 50-yard line. Don't really want one of those on your stats.
49 and a half yard line. First and 10, Finland.
Just shy of the 50-yard line is where the ball is being placed. Game clock needs to be reset to 1:15 by order of the referee. First and 10, Finland. Might have to eat my hat here if they score. I said they wouldn't. But 1:15 is more than enough time to get the ball into the end zone. Pass out to Heckley, a little bit short. Incomplete.
They just well off that pass wasn't completed because it kept the clock running and it only made 4 or 5 yards.
Big lineman, number 65, is down for Finland.
We have an injured player on the field.
Hannes Mattila.
Some could possibly question the whether the injury was authentic or not, but the clock was stopped anyway, so.
I've been known through the years as a head coach to have a player fall down inside the 2-minute warning just to give me a little bit more time.
You just dealt the profession a serious blow there.
Sorry,
Coach. We have made vast attempts to make people believe we never do that.
Second down and 10 from the 50-yard line. Finland looking to pass. Down the right side. Almost complete, but not really. Well defended by the Swedish cornerback, number 24.
Third and 10.
Jungstedt.
One of the problems with number 11 is he outruns his quarterback.
6 seconds remaining of this bronze game in the first World University Championship.
He's got long legs. You'd have
today's
to account for that. Had long legs with speed, and
he was by the quarterback on that particular play. Not immensely so, but enough. If the ball would have been hung out there, he could have got it.
Brings up third down and 10 to go for the Finns from the 50-yard line. 1:06 on the clock. Burnson in a bit of trouble there. Throwing the ball deep to Sintu, overthrows his receiver. Flag in the backfield.
I'd like to see him be able to throw that ball to his to Hector.
Brings up fourth down for the Finns after a holding call. As Coach Bilgren gets doused with water at the sideline.
Well, I expect that's just a little bit chilly.
That's real chilly because they had ice in that bucket.
I'm a little cool right here just standing with a good coat on.
Picture of Coach Bilgren there. In a wet shirt.
That's a happy wet shirt, though.
Burnson looking to throw once again, nowhere to go. Finally lets it loose. Oh, had an open receiver in the middle, but it's overthrowing.
Well, Team Finland certainly put up a
expect the Swedes to take the
worthwhile attempt to pull out a win for Team Finland, the bronze medal. But it certainly looks like it's going in.
52 seconds remaining of the game. Sweden's up.
The homeland of Sweden. All they got to do is kneel on it two times.
Sweden will take the victory formation here, kneel the ball. Final result of today's game will be 28 for Sweden, 6 for Finland.
Quarterback Joachim Nilsson takes a knee to run the clock down, second down.
They'll need to knee the ball one more time to end the game. And that will bring the end of the game number 9. The final score is 28-6, Finland under Sweden.
And that is the end of the game. Sweden finishes in a third place.
Game started out as a even match, and then Sweden got up quick with 14 points. Never really looked back after that.
No, they were, the first half was pretty even half, really. I thought a couple of large pass plays for Sweden was basically the difference in the game, plus the turnover that Finland lost there at the end of their first drive. I thought that those three plays were basically the difference in the first half. But Sweden pretty well owned the second half. They did. Their offensive line came in and established themselves very well. Here's the most valuable players being announced.
The most valuable player for today's game in Team Finland goes to number 11, Marcus
Häckley. Your prediction, coach?
Well, he would have certainly been one of two guys I would have considered.
91 yards, the longest catch for 27 yards.
91 yards reception on the day.
And for Team Sweden, the most valuable player goes to number 9.
And Fabian Söderberg off the Swedish side gets the most valuable player.
That's a fun deal. His father
slaps the hand of all of his.
Gets to award his son most valuable player. That's got to be thrilling for both of them.
Gets a little bit of a hug there from dad on the after getting the MVP.
Rushing yards as well as 12 reception yards. Congratulations to both players.
Marcus Häckley of Finland receiving the MVP, as is Fabian Söderberg of Sweden. As the teams thank each other for a great tournament, puts Sweden in the puts Team Sweden into third place in the tournament. And that brings the end of our broadcast for you.
Well, it gets us down to one game.
We got to watch a complete game there,
yeah,
Coach.
Yeah, and it gets us down to one game tomorrow at this time between in the gold medal match.
And tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock is the kickoff time for Mexico-Japan in the final of this tournament.
Two very fast teams. It'll be real interesting tomorrow to see how that turns out.
And here's the table for the day. Japan still on top, followed by Mexico. Sweden in a clear third place with a minus 56. Finland in fourth with a minus 112. And China bringing up the rear with minus 197.
Those of you that may be unfamiliar with the team or the table there, the percentage out to the far right column is the percentage of wins versus losses.
We have two undefeated teams going into the final tomorrow afternoon. Not much of a point spread between them. And here's some highlights from the first half of the game. Coach and I are going to go down to the interview room in the media center. And we'll call that a thank you and good night from Will Peterson and Mike Kearsley. And tune in tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock for Japan versus Sweden, or Japan versus Mexico. Thank you and good night.